In this video, we'll share some things to consider before you go into the classroom to teach an activity using PhET. The PhET website has many resources for teachers as they integrate the simulations into their instruction. First, you can search for simulations using various keywords. Each simulation page has a list of the learning goals that the simulation is designed to address, as well as links to activities that other teachers have developed for use with that simulation. You can easily locate the activities developed by the PhET team, which are indicated by the PhET logo. You can also browse activities, filtering by the simulation, your grade level, or the type of activity you are looking for. You can use these activities as they are or modify them for your needs. Before you finalize your classroom activity, there are a few things that can be useful to do.
These PhETs are so deep, there's so much in them. But play around with it so you can predict what kinds of things that the kids might struggle with. Take a look at the supports online, look at the other lesson plans that people have written.
For a teacher to use the PhET simulation most effectively, they need to know how to use it themselves. I know Ms. Lobline really had a control over how the simulations worked. So if you had any questions, she would come over and provide us more explanation on something.
If you haven't spent your own time getting familiar with that simulation and with the activity, you're not going to know the spots that they get stuck at, and you're not going to know which things to point out.
Playing with the simulation also gives you a chance to explore what the simulation does and does not do. Knowing this can help make sure that your activity aligns with what the simulation can actually do. You can also make note of any tools or features in the simulation that are particularly relevant to the activity's learning goals. You'll want to make sure that these are highlighted during class discussion.
Once you've either created your own activity or you maybe have taken an activity from the website, I would definitely recommend going through the activity as if you were a student. Because that's, I think, the time when you're going to realize, oh, there's actually more than one way to do this. I need to be prepared for that.
We suggest focusing each simulation activity on a few student learning goals, which include content and process goals. See our separate video on designing activities for more information. Here are some example process goals you might consider: communicating ideas in groups, designing an experiment, developing a strategy to address a challenge, or making claims from evidence collected in the simulation. Making note of particular process goals that you would like to focus on can help you remember them, as well as to look for opportunities to facilitate student learning of these goals during class. Our Tips for Teachers portion of our website has many resources to help you think about how to best use PhET with your students. The other videos in this series will walk you through the various aspects of using PhET activities successfully in your classroom.